Hi, I'm Panagiotis Fiulas, and today I'm going to present work that we did at EPFL with Victor Sanka, Ioannis Mitilinis, and Anastasia Elamaki. Complex workloads contain hidden parallelization opportunities that as of yet remain unexploited due to inter-query dependencies. In this work, we saw that by using speculation, we can relax dependencies, parallelize the queries, and improve performance. To provide low latency responses, small and large organizations alike have switched to analytical engines that exploit data and task parallelism in workloads in order to scale up and out. However, despite the best efforts of the analytical engines, a broad class of workloads, such as queries that contain group by views, correlated queries, and nested group bys, produce operator patterns that restrict task parallelism. Consider the case of a correlated query, the plan of which we see below. The plan is split in two parts, the inner part highlighted in red and the outer part highlighted in blue. And it executes as follows. It computes a group by aggregate over the catalog sales fact table. And then in the outer part, for its tuple of store sales, it applies a filter, and for satisfying tuples, it compares the sales price attribute with an aggregate from the inner part. And depending on the comparison, it decides whether to add the tuple in the group by or not. Now, it's evident that to execute the semi-join, we need to have full access to the results of the inner query. And therefore, we have serialization. We have to execute this before the outer part. Then analytical engines only have one execution schedule, to execute the inner part in a fully data parallel way, and then the outer part in a full data parallel way without any overlap. This approach is often suboptimal. Consider an execution timeline. Data parallel execution is optimal when data parallelism provides linear speedup. However, this is far from the truth. We run the example query in a 3-worker Apache Spark cluster with TPCD scale factor 100 data cast in memory. We plot the results, and on the x-axis we have the number of cores, on the y-axis we have the execution time breakdown. As the degree of parallelism is increased, we observe diminishing returns due to group by shuffles and broadcast joins. Between 24 and 48 cores, we see little performance improvement. Now consider an alternative execution schedule based on task parallelism, which is however impossible to use because of serialization. Then we split the resources evenly between the two parts, execute them in parallel, and the execution time is that of the longest running part. So therefore, task parallel execution is more efficient than serialized one. Also, if we were talking about queries that have common sub-expressions between the outer and the inner part, then we can even use work sharing to further improve performance. In this work, we make such task parallel schedules possible. Specifically, we propose a novel execution paradigm based on speculation that predicts the results of the inner part and then uses those predictions in order to execute the inner and the outer part in parallel. Of course, predictions can be inaccurate, and therefore we use a repair mechanism to guarantee correctness at the end of execution. In the rest of the presentation, I'm going to go through a speculative execution step by step. First, we saw how we resolve dependencies using speculation. This amounts to executing the outer part of the query without having access to the results of the inner part. For our example, the dependency works as follows. For every tuple that goes through the filter, let them be the table here, we have to compare the sales price attribute with an aggregate from the inner part. However, the aggregate is not yet available at this point. Therefore, this becomes a branch prediction problem. And based on the prediction, we perform useful work if we accurately predict that the tuple has to be aggregated, or we have to take a reparative action later on. Now, we have two overheads, prediction overhead and repair overhead. And to strike a balance between the two, we use approximate query processing to build highly accurate data-aware predictors that require orders of magnitude less execution time than fully executing the inner part. Then, by using the approximation in place of the inner part, we can estimate the branch condition and execute the outer part in a speculative manner. This methodology can work in any case where the inner part is approximable and the result of the approximation is only involved in the branch condition. Of course, approximations have errors, and the errors can affect branch conditions. We compare, for the example, the estimated branch condition values and the actual branch condition values if we were given the results of the inner part. We see that there is a difference. The second tuple was processed when it shouldn't have, and the third tuple wasn't processed when it should have. Both of these mispredictions affect the results, and therefore we have to take action. To do that, we introduce two novel operators. The first operator is SVJoin. SVJoin has two execution paths. The first execution path substitutes the semi-join and performs the same work. It processes the input of the semi-join, produces the same output, but also it indexes branch prediction decisions on the fly. Then this is used in the second execution path, which consumes the results of the inner part to validate branch predictions. It converts the branch condition into a selective predicate and uses the index in order to find mispredicted tuples. Then, in order to avoid a full recomputation, mispredicted tuples are expressed as delta tuples and are used in a repair plan, borrowing ideas from incremental view maintenance. Finally, a guard operator consumes the result of speculative execution and the repair plan and puts them together to produce correct query results. Now let's consider the comparison of the execution timeline of speculative execution compared to serialized execution. Speculative execution performs two tasks in parallel. It processes the inner part, and in parallel, it performs the speculation and processes the outer part. Once both of these tasks are done, it performs validation and repair. However, validation and repair involve orders of magnitude fewer data than actual execution, and therefore they're very fast. So the situation in the results is almost paradoxical. We have more work to do, but we do it in less time. And this is because parallelization is more efficient. In this example, we see 23% less execution time. Now we try to generalize the results for more queries coming from TIPCDS benchmark. We use the same experimental setup and execute only the relevant TIPCDS queries, that is, queries that involve the results of a group by in a conditional dependency or have an exist predicate. We approximate the former with a stratified sample and the latter with a Bloom filter. On the x-axis, we have the name of the queries. On the y-axis, we have the speedup of speculative execution over the best parallel schedule for this query. And also, we color bars with blue if speedup comes only from task parallelism, and green if it comes from both task parallelism and sharing. We observe speedups ranging from 1.2 to 2.2 based on the relative cost of the inner and the outer part. And we see that despite decreasing data parallelism in each query part, increasing the task parallelism pays off. Overall, we saw that pure data parallelism suffers from diminishing returns. And while task parallelism can mitigate this effect, it's not always an option. In this work, we saw that speculative execution allows us to exploit task parallelism in workloads where it was not possible before, interdependent queries. To do that, we use approximations as data-aware predictors, which to our knowledge is a novel application of approximate query processing. In this work, we have focused on nested subqueries, but we plan to extend the scope of the work beyond this workload. Two workloads that we have already identified is control flow patterns, which use the result of a query to decide which query to execute next, and iterative algorithms, which have deep dependency chains. We look forward to having more results to share in this direction. Thank you very much for your attention.